prayer by the preacher, Jehovah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Holy Michael.
Amen.
You are the Lord, let your name be glorified.
Amen.
Father, we are about to fellowship in your words. Father, come and speak out yourself in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever you are going to speak through me, O Lord Father, let it be of you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And let it be fruitful in our minds in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for prayer, son.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray.
Amen. 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 In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh,
this place.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
What is this?
Mimo!
I'm going to sing a song.
You are the one.
Yo!
Who can question God? We can't. Without love, without her, the God loved her more than we do. Our thoughts are with the family. And I pray to the Lord that God will grant them the family and the church of the Lord the fortitude to bear the loss in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Such a bad happening will never happen in this church again in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to say something. I've been hearing a lot of things. You know, I work here. Don't say anything that will make you to sin against God. Please. The Bible says, guide your tongue. And the book of James chapter 1 verse 26 or so, it said, if a man feels that he's worshiping the Lord and cannot guide his tongue or her tongue, the worship of that person is in vain. Our worship will not be in vain in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I've been hearing that, are there no prophets in that element that's in the church? That they haven't seen it. They haven't seen the death coming. Let somebody go to the book of 2 Kings chapter 4, I think verse 27. It is not everything that God shows the prophet and the prophetesses. He shows them what he wants them to know.
When she reached the mouth of God at the mountain,
yes,
she took hold of his feet.
That is the issue of the woman and the son of the woman of a Shunammite that died when Elisha was passing that through that place. And Elisha used to lodge in the house of that woman. But when Elisha and Gehazi has left, Elisha died. And they sent for Elisha. Yes, my brother.
Gehazi came over to push her away.
Yes.
But the man of God said, leave her alone.
He said, leave her alone. When she saw the woman coming to Elisha with anger. Yes.
She is in bitter distress.
She's in bitter distress.
But the Lord has hidden it from me.
That is what Elisha. Elisha was saying that, how can this thing happen? And the Lord has not shown it to me. Yes?
And has not told me why.
God has not told me why. He has taken that child. Thank you very much. So you who are blaming this prophet or prophetesses, you are committing a very grievous sin. Because it's not everything that God will show his prophet or prophetesses. And that is why I said you cannot query or question God for what has happened. My joy is that Maria has lived a very good life. She has not offended anybody. A divorce of a man is the voice of God. Well, we can say, she's a very humble, she's a very good, quiet woman, she's this and that. Then the angels in the heaven, they are recording it. So I'm very happy that she is resting in the bosom of our God. What about you? A food for thought. We will go straight to the lesson that was read to our hearing. I will tag this my sermon as call to repentance. Call to repentance. In the first book of in the book of Hosea that was read to our hearing, the two lessons there, they are practically the same thing. So I will blend the two together for the little period I've given, 40 or 45 minutes. Let somebody read Hosea chapter 14, verses 1 and 2, please.
O Israel,
yes.
Return unto the Lord,
yes.
Thy God, for thou hast fallen by thy iniquity. Take with you words,
yes.
And turn to the Lord. Say unto him, take away all iniquity and receive us graciously.
Yes.
So will we render the calves of our lips.
Thank you very much, please. This is a prophet of God. Prophet of God. God sent prophet Hosea to the Israelites. He said, take away all this your sinful ways and return to me. Take away your sinful ways and repent and return to me, your God. The book of Jeremiah chapter 2 verse 19, it says, my people has committed two sins, two evils. They have forsaken me the living water, and they have taken the stem that cannot hold water, the broken one. When you want to take water with a broken glass or a broken bottle, can it hold? It cannot hold. So this is what we have done before the Lord. The Lord says, come to me. I am the living water that you can come to. Like he said, the house of the Lord is a righteous place that where you run to and you'll be saved. But what do you do in the house of the Lord? You commit sin with your mouth. You chase away the angels of the Lord who are supposed to take your prayers unto the Lord. We are committing a lot of sins. And that is why the Lord says, all has fallen short of God's glory. I think in Romans 8:23, he said, we have come short of God's glory. And then we have to come to repentance so that we can be saved. And that's why the Lord gave us Jesus Christ. Because we have fallen short of God's glory through Adam and Eve, our forefathers, who sinned against the Lord in the Garden of Eden. And they were chased out. They were disqualified. They were rejected from the actual plan of the Lord for mankind, which was, be fruitful. Have dominion over all the things I have created. They have dominion over all creations of the Lord. But because of their sins, because they have announced Satan, who came in serpent's cloth, to deceive them, and they were chased away out of the Garden of Eden. But thank God for his kindness, for his mercy. He sent Jesus Christ to come and redeem us so that we can be saved, so that the Lord's glory can be restored back to us. And that is why he said in the book of Colossians chapter 1, I think verse 27 or 29, he said, Christ in us, God bless you. We lost one glory through somebody, Adam and Eve, and God restored it back through Jesus Christ, his son. It is that Jesus Christ that we say you should come and worship. It is that Jesus Christ that we say you should come and bow down for. It is that Jesus Christ that we say you should emulate his ways. But instead of doing that, we start following our own ways. They taught us in the school, the Bible College, TCCI. They said, this year, thank you. We saw this Gandhi man, Mahatma Gandhi. He said, if all Christians can behave like Christ, he said, the whole world will be Christians. If we should behave like Christ, follow his ways, he said that will be enough to convince the whole world to become Christians. Me and you, we are Christians. We behave like Christ in our ways, in our deeds. I am righteous. I don't commit sin. And this is a lie. I know of a woman. She's not here now. When she was looking for papers, she was coming here begging me and Baba Raluki to pray for him. For her. She was rolling on the floor. She was crying. She was doing this. She was doing that. And the voice of the Lord, through our prophet, he said, you are going to be given. She comes here every day. Now she has taken her papers. Since she has taken her papers, I have never seen her in the church for once or twice. Then you want to blame God for giving her papers? That is it. That is one of the ways that we are committing sins. But we have forgotten that the Lord says that I am the one who is going to teach you how to make profit and direct your ways. Let us come to repentance. Because our Lord is a good God. He loves us so much. And that verse, says, somebody read Hosea chapter 14, verse 3 for me, please. Those are one of the ways that we commit sins against God. Idols
shall not save us.
Idols. That is what they mean by Ashton. Ashton is the name of their idol, well, that they worship. Idols will not save us. Yes?
We will not ride upon horses.
We will not ride upon horses. Psalm 20 says some trust, they trust in chariot. Some trust in horses. What? Let somebody read for me, please. Psalm 20. They fell down. They could not stand because they didn't put their trust in God. Yes? Yeah.
And some in horses. But we will remember the Lord our God. They are brought down and fallen.
That is those people that have
risen up.
That they have their trust in horses and in war chariots. Then why don't you come to that God, the living God, and serve Him? The Bible says in Matthew 6:37, He says, "Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. Every other thing shall be." Somebody who has taken his job as his God, her God now, he has not sought the kingdom of the Lord and his righteousness. Because he has made his job to be his service. And you know the vision of Job? J-O-B, just over broke. Yes, that is it. No matter how you walk, if you don't have God, by your side is nothing. Because the Lord you are serving is a very jealous God. In the book of Exodus, He said, "I am a jealous God. You should not serve any other idol." If you are taking your job to be your God, you love your job personal. You take your job as number one. You take the preeminence of your life, then you are committing sin. I'm not saying you shouldn't work, but don't take that job as your priority for disturbing you from coming to the church to come and serve the Lord. It is the Lord that makes you to profit, and He can always direct your ways. That is that. Now, there are some people here too that you don't know that this God you are serving is everywhere. The eyes of the Lord is celestial logo. He looks at everywhere you are. Committing adultery and fornication. Stealing and telling lies. You are becoming, your wife calls you, say, "Where are you?" "Oh, am I in Birmingham?" And you are committing a sin where you are. If your wife doesn't see you, or by your will. So these are the things that we do. These are that we pray, and the prayers are not answered. He said, "Come to me. Come to me. Repent and come to me so that you can be saved." John the Baptist in the second lesson. John the Baptist came before the Lord, our Lord Jesus Christ, to come and proclaim the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he has to baptize them before the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ. That was the second lesson. And when he was baptizing, the Sadducees and the Pharisees, even they knew that, yes, they had to be baptized. And they ran to John the Baptist to be baptized. I say something there. Let somebody go to Matthew chapter 3. Go to verse 6 or 7.
Where baptism of him, and were baptized by him, of him in Jerusalem.
Yes.
Sorry, Jordan, confessing their sin. Mm-hmm. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to him, to him baptism, he said unto them, O generations of vipers, who have warned you of to flee from the wrath of to come, bring forth thereof fruits meet for repentance, and think not to say within yourself, we have Abraham to our father.
Thank you very much. I just want to use my saying. He said, bring forth, therefore, fruits meet for repentance. We have to bring fruit for repentance. We are not saying this for saying sake, but we are saying this so that it can touch our mind and we can repent from our ways. You know where you are offending God. I know where I am offending God. And you know where you are falling short of God's glory. You know what you are doing in your process, but you have to repent because the time is coming. The time is coming. One of our songs that the choristers, I thank you so much, and I'm so much impressed about you people. When you come on when they come on Saturday for practice, you will first of all look at the lessons of tomorrow, first and second lesson, and they will deliberate in it before they will start their practice, which is very good. Very, very good. Hymn 582 that you sang. Jesus is coming from the heaven above. Yes? Jesus is coming. That was
someone.
With all the host of the angels. He is coming to crown us.
With
his beloved. Behold, my heart is ready to meet Jesus Christ. Because he died for my sin. Behold, my heart is willing to meet Jesus Christ. Because he died for us. God bless you. And then if you know, and if you realize that Jesus Christ died for your sin, then what are you waiting for? Than to come closer to him. Than to do his will. That you forsake that old man. Because the Bible says, reject and forsake that old man. It was the old man that put us into trouble in the kind of Eden. It was him. Then why don't you refuse and reject him totally so that you can be saved? Jesus Christ came because of me and you. He died because he has come to pay the price. The Lord's glory was restored back to the death of Jesus Christ. The veil of the temple got torn when Jesus Christ died. That means there's no boju-boju, there's no anything, there's no hidden thing between you and your God. You have to see God directly, you have to talk to God directly. In the olden days, they don't have that privilege. But now we have the privilege of talking to God directly as a result of Jesus Christ's death. Then, because you have been given that opportunity, how are you making use of that opportunity? Don't let that opportunity elude you. God does not, it has been appointed for all of us to die once. After what? God bless you. The Bible commands that it has been appointed for man to die once. And after that death, there's judgment. Our sister has gone to the bosom part of Jesus Christ. He has gone. She has gone. There's nothing she can do now. All what she has done when she was on earth is between her and God. Tomorrow can be my turn. Tomorrow can be your turn. What are you going to tell God when you reach there? In 551. Sing it, please. Yeah. Don't sit with that city. Yes. I don't have time. I have only 5 minutes or 15 minutes more. Yes. Calling you to repentance. If you are coming to this church, that is not your ultimate, but your character with God, your relationship with God. So people can be coming to the church without anything. Just come and just go. If you are coming to the church, does not impact God's way. It does not impact the knowledge of God into others. The others cannot look at you and copy you. Then your copies should be in vain. If you are living with unbelievers and they could not see any difference between you and them, then you have become you have missed it. And the hellfire is straight. I saw some Christians, I will not mention names. The way they dressed, it was a nice one. Start late, finish early. You know what that means?
No.
Start late, and at the bottom, finish early. Whom are you impressing? Whom are you impressing? There's no difference between you and unbeliever. When you go to disco, you wear that kind of a thing, and then people will be lowering you to something that you don't even care for. You don't want. You live with your mates, maybe in the university or in the hostel or in the house or anywhere. They should see the Son of God in you. They should know that, oh, this man is a Christian. Oh, this woman is a Christian. Not that you'll be fighting everybody on the street. Your neighbors, they take you as a pagan. In the church, no. Don't go to her. She's a fighter. Those are the things that we do. It's not when you commit adultery or you do this or do that. Little things. The Bible says, little sins cannot come to God. Kekere, ninu, eshe, ninu, eshe, ninu, eshe, ninu, eshe, ninu, eshe, ninu, eshe. Thank you very much. The second stanza says, you that has been driven away from Garden of Eden, that should be a food for thought for you that you have to think. We were down
Quasi ube imore, ube imore.
And where is that place?
Mi piti Jesu Toba, mi wadu vite baba.
Ereche,
kudu piwa.
Again, you are coming to the church. You are just a bench warmer. Evangelical committee, you are not that. You are not there. Policemen that are using their talent to worship God, you are not there. Besides men that are on their legs, controlling the gate, you are not there.
Then, where are you, please? You are neither cold nor hot.
He said, I'm going to speak them out of my mouth. You don't do anything in the house of the Lord. Then why are you coming here? What's your calling? You are neither anybody. You are neither a prophet. You are neither a policeman. You are neither this or that. You always fly about here and there. There's one prophet my friend that is Bono. There's another one that is that. Then there's another one in Edward Castle that is Bono. Is that Bono that you are looking about? No, we have to repent. We have to take it back our life. If you are being called today, I say, if you are being called today, what are you going to tell the Lord? My brethren, the Lord, this is a food for thought. This is a time that we have to reflect. This is a time of sober reflection. What has happened for the past few days now, it is enough to teach us a lesson. That we have to repent. Anybody can die at any time. Either you watch God, you serve God, you don't serve God, you can die. I am not trying to create fear in your mind, but you have to think that if tomorrow should be my end, Lord, what will I do? What will I do? You have to serve the Lord. Some of you are very, 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 very arrogant. You are very, very proud. God has given you a. God has prepared a bowl of honey for you. Then He only gave you just a teaspoonful of that honey. Say, take. He wants to use that one to test you. Then you bought two or three properties. You are riding a big car. You have some money in your bank. That is part of the small honey, teaspoonful of honey that God has given to you. That is what is worth. Whereas He has another bowl, a full bowl of honey prepared for you. But the money has not given you just that teaspoonful. Then you started. I have arrived. Then what will he do? He will just take that basin, just take it away. I'm just giving him a little something, and he's proud of it. Take the rest away. That is how we miss our blessings. That's how we miss the plan of God for us. Look at what happened to Adam and Eve. God created them as a food, as a companion, to fellowship with them. He comes to every now and then to come and see Adam. He has a lot of things for them, a lot of goodies. He has a lot of plans for them. In that garden where they are, there's a tree, a fruit of a long life, where you will not die again. There we have the fruit of knowledge and this thing there. Yeah, because they were so much in a hurry, somebody deceived them, they plucked it and they ate. And God disqualified them. All the things that they were entitled to, all the plans of God. And that is why we die. Because God did not create us to come and die. Yeah, because they were too much in a hurry. The same thing me and you. Sometimes we do things that we're too much in a hurry. We know more than God. We don't want to wait for God's time. Yeah, well, it is, we end up in losing what God has prepared for us. But we don't want to lose God's glory in Jesus' name. Let me know, please, repent and come to the Lord. The book of Isaiah says, if your sins are as red as scarlet, he said, I will still take you back. Look at the story of that prodigal son, Omoninokuna. He went away. He took all his father's his own part of the will, inheritance. He said, my father, come and give me. No. I'm going away. I know you are very rich. Okay, give me my own portion of the medicine when you die, before you die. Huh? Somebody has not died. And he said you should check his will. He said, my son, don't do that. No. My this is the way I want it. Okay. The man gave it to him. And he went away. When he blew everything, finished everything with all this life, chop life, then he came back again. He said, oh, the father could drive him away. No. He took him back. The Lord says, I will not discard you. I will not push you away, even if you sin against me in so that way. But I just want you to come to repentance so that you can be saved. We read Psalm 51 every now and then. Psalm 51, Lord, have mercy upon me according to your reason, according to that, and this and that. The second day again, watch. You are not supposed to do it, you will do it. And you come again, say, Lord, have mercy upon me, and then one day. One day will be one day. Keep on reading. One day will be one day. Where you will? Where? And you won't have the opportunity to read that chapter to one again. Please, I have to shift you. Take away pride from your life. Pride goes before all destruction. He said in that Matthew chapter, he said, they will lay axe on the root of that particular tree that bear not good fruit. Are you bearing good fruit? I don't want you to reply to respond, but think in your heart, am I bearing good fruit? Let somebody read it for me, please.
Bring forth therefore fruit meet for repentance.
Yes.
And think not to say within yourself, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that God is able of this stone to
raise. Please go to that particular place where he said they are going to lay axe on the root of the fruit or the tree that does not bear fruit.
And now,
yes.
Also the axe is laid unto the root of the tree. Therefore, every tree which bringeth not fruit. Not bring forth fruit is killed down and cast into the fire.
That is the rule. That will not be a portion in Jesus' name. Axe will be there on the feet or the foot of the beast that could not bear fruit. Your character is another thing. You cannot be presented to your own generation. God cannot present you to your generation if your character is questionable. If Baba Chiesa, sorry to use that example, if Baba Chiesa character is questionable, do you think people will stay here? They won't wait here. You only see about 4 or 10 people that are for the same character with him. If God cannot present you to your generation, if your character is questionable, please, you cannot mock God. What you sow is what you are going to reap. You can only hide, but you cannot run. You set all the catchy colleagues. Change. As I'm telling you, I'm telling myself. That
you see, preaching is about war, sword. As you are telling them, you are telling yourself as well. I will not push them. Because there are some things that I do that while I'm preaching now, it's coming back to me as well. And I don't want anybody to come and meet me after this. I'm a hero. Please, man of God, you are talking to me. I'm not talking to anybody. I think I'll tell you. That is why I said, what I'm telling you affects me as well. Please, I think I'll tell you. Brethren, the Lord. Now, since Jesus Christ has restored the glory, what we need to see to do is mend your ways with the Lord, and the Lord will save you.
Amen.
Thank you for listening.
Amen.